Okay, let's do a live repair of a Dell laptop. I haven't even opened it up. Hopefully nothing in here. Weird. Okay. This one apparently has a charging issue, maybe. Type C, okay. That's what I've been told. Type C. Okay. So this is a Dell P67G, so it looks like a Latitude family. Nice. Yeah, it's 7370. So it's quite a nice laptop. It's one of the business lines. So let's have a look what the issue is. So, adapter says I've got charge. Does this model have any charging indicator around it? Anything? A couple of screws are off. Okay, try the other port. Okay, try the other way. Try this way. Something flash on the screen. Try that again. Okay, this is not, in my opinion, a charger issue. We can confirm. I'll bring in a 5 volt, which can go up to 9 volts. Nothing. 0.1 and then stop. Okay. Doesn't feel like liquid. Let's have a look on the inside. What's going on? Screw is already loose, so someone had opened this up. They've been doing a lot of eating. Okay, let's just get some measurements. What's going on? Battery's dead. Clock is fine. Why is the battery dead? Why is it not talking? Okay. Okay, yeah, So when we plug in the charger, something should happen here. We've got nothing happening. Okay, so let's have a quick look around the board. Just looking for any voltages. Just anything. That's the type C controller there. Okay. Can use this guy. Really, nothing? Try my phone. Okay, this way it's working. But it hasn't negotiated any higher voltage. Okay. We have another Dell here. This guy works fine. Okay, let's have a look internally. Mm-hmm. of this port. See if there is any physical damages on the inside. Let's have a look on the microscope. So we can conclude that they may have used a charger or something that may have damaged. Okay, let's inject some voltage here, say 6 volts, an amp, 1 amp. Okay. The battery is refusing to take any charge. Okay, let's go voltage. Yeah, we can see 6.7 volts going there, but nothing's happening. Guy does want to turn on. Okay, gotcha. See, we'll work out the battery. Okay. How can I show you? Okay. Do the power switch. Okay. Let's go 7.78. We'll increase the amps because probably want a lot of amps. Okay, there we go. Now the unit will turn on. So we've got power, live power at the moment. Let's get a nice stable view. Give me a ground. Okay, power on. Shit, come on. Come on, turn on. We should see something now. Come on, it's bullshit. Can't hold it long enough. So it turns off after a while, okay. How about voltage? We increase the voltage. Nine volts. Okay, here we go. Oh, by the way, Dell has diagnostic lights, right? I forgot. I'm gonna look at the screen because I can't get the orientation right. Just gonna check that power button. Okay. Okay. and then it shuts down. Pretty much exact same time. I can see a graph in my end here. Watts. Boom. Now, pretty much the same. So he's not even responding to power button if I hold it. No. Okay, let's plug in the... Let's turn this off, we don't want this power anymore. No, nothing. So, what is the problem? Thank you. Better late than never.
Thank you.
Okay, is there any point checking for resistance to crowns? Really? Okay, so we do have a problem. And I fear possibly the worst. Okay. So, there's a short summary here. Now, this is really the nice trick to see the ESR meter in action. Okay, so I don't know what I'm going to show you. Let me figure it out. One sec. Maybe what we can do. Alright. I'm gonna try and use ESR meter to find the shore. Okay, so first thing first, important, let's have a look at our cable's own resistance at the tip. Okay, I'm gonna say 102. That's very important. This side we read 183. So we're reading 1.75, and this side so the short is on this side.
Thank you.
My name is?
The name is?
SureCanDo.
Thank you.
Okay, let's do this again. Let's get a same ground. Do it one more time. Okay. One point so minus 1.38. So we get 0.36 ohms short the ground there. Now the other side. Let's say 1.75. Obviously we can see the short is on this side. Good. Now let's see if we can find it deeper. That looks like a fuse. This is probably our cable resistance. That's fine. Okay, let's continue. There's something there. Okay. 1.4. Could be that cap, could be ground. So these two are quite similar. How about these guys? Because they're also shorted, yeah? Could be one of these guys. 1.4 1.39. Go back to here. Imagine that's the guy that's shorted. I'll be amazed if that was it. Okay. Alright, so how about this? What's the chance of that guy being the culprit? What if that's the ground leg? Okay, let me have a look in continuity. Where else is shorted? They're all going to be shorted, aren't they? So that's some sort of an inductor. Oh, short is gone. That's ground. Okay. That's an inductor. I'm gonna push this guy as possible culprit. One volt, one amp, one kilowatt. We'll put one volt here. Let's see what happens, okay? Let's go. One volt. Okay, 6 amps, no. Bring that down to one amp. Enter on. Now we got voltage. Okay, here we go. Okay, so let's bring in the injection. Okay. Okay, that's not a good ground. Nope, that's the wrong probe, okay. Good, the power is going somewhere. Let's bring Mr. Alcohol, I think. Better mark this box. I keep getting the wrong chemical. Okay, let's increase the amps. Okay, here we go. 2 amps, okay. Okay, can't see. Let's go 3 amps. Shit. Okay. We're gonna start a fire soon. Unless the short is on the other side. Could be the Type-C controller there. Okay, I'm gonna have to bring the thermal cam. See where the short is. Nothing? So it's on the other side? Okay. One sec. Okay, here we go. Back there again. Okay, hopefully nothing in the CPU area. I'm going to remove the heat shield. Technically, if it was the charging port, computer would have still turned on from the battery power source, and it did not. Hopefully, it's not the worst case scenario. Okay. There's another Type-C controller. Let's quickly check that. I'm going to inject power again. Okay, here we go. Okay, let's get a good ground. .84, nothing. So what's getting hot? Try again. I don't like removing this board, but looks like I have no choice. Okay. Yeah, this is a very ugly design of a motherboard. Too messy. Okay. Let's go old school and remove that coil. So let's see if the ESR meter was correct, that the short was on that side. Correct. Short is on this side. We are correct. Okay. Now with the coil removed, let's go ahead and inject power again. See if anything does get hot. So what we'll do, use traditional method. Okay. 1 volt, okay. Try one more time. So 3 amps is going somewhere and I don't even know what's getting hot. This is bullshit. It's gotta be him. Look. See that? Nothing. Put the power. See that? There we go. Right there. He's a doner kebab. Alright, confirmed. U925. What do I do with you? So I don't have this chip. Maybe I'm not searching correctly. U625, sorry. Z969. Still nothing, what the hell? U625 Z969, yeah. How about the bottom number? DSL 6540. Okay, Intel DSL 6540 Thunderbolt 3 controller. Okay. So what do we do about this? Okay. I'll have a look around the board and see what I've got. Okay, so I think I'm going to leave it at this one for now. I'll quote the client, see if they want to go ahead, and we'll order the chip and go from there. So yeah, thanks for watching. See you. Should we remove it? See if the short goes away. Why not? Okay, here we go. Anyway, so it looks like all our pads are there, which is fine. And just check if the short is still there. To ground. No short. Also, this board seems to be playing up. If that port is loose, I wonder when it was loose, maybe some of the pins touch each other. Just taking the lid out. Yeah, look at that. All those pads are gone and they've touched something and they're naturally killed. Yeah. Okay. So it needs a new port. This one, oh shit, this one's open. Wow. Okay, that explains a lot. Okay, why this problem happened. Okay, major problems. Alright. Okay, so at least we know what happened and why this problem happened. So that chip got killed by pins touching each other from, yeah, whatever. Okay, so I'll quote the client, most likely a no-go, major issues, see what they want to do. No wonder why when we move it around, it will sometimes work, sometimes wouldn't. Okay. We'll still give them a quote, see what they want to do, and based on that, we'll put it all together. Anyway, we'll put it all back later on. All the screws. Okay, thanks for watching. See you in the next one.